If God has been good to you on this mountain, scripture says, better is the end of a thing than the beginning thereof. Lift up your voice and thank him for the diversities of encounter, for the transformations. Lord, I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. I give you thanks. I give you adoration. Faithful God, I thank you. Blessed be your holy name. Waymaker, story changer, door opener, I give you praise. I give you glory. Blessed be your holy name. For the blessings appointed, for the manifestation of your glory, manifestation of your wonders, we give you all the praise, we give you all the thanks, all adoration. Faithful God, we say thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Your frustration has finally come to an end. If you are saying amen, say better amen. I say again, your frustration has finally come to an end. Every plan of hell marked out against you is disappointed. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Every arrangement of wickedness concerning you is disappointed. You will fulfill destiny this year. If you are saying amen, say better amen. You will not suffer any form of limitation in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, the heavens are opening for you. The heavens are opening over your family. The heavens are opening over your business. So shall it be. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. If you are saying amen, say better amen. It is my new dawn era. What eyes have not seen, what ears have not heard, shall be the order of the day in my life. Congratulations. Amen and amen. Put those hands together for the Lord and please be seated. Please, I want to encourage everyone. We have prayed. We have bind. We have cast. It's time to go and register for your card. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? We have said, fire! Burn them. It's time for us to go and collect our card. Are you hearing me now? So please, everybody, I'll be hammering it every day, every day. We must go and collect our card. In Jesus' name. So please, everybody, don't say that the queue is long. There's no queue. You just go collect and you can verify it. You can verify whether you are duly registered. Let me say this again. Please, ushers, ushering people to this front row, I beg you in the name of God, don't bring people with phone that will come and distract us. How will we be in service? So your phone will not be ringing. You now walk out and come back. You don't try that in Living Faith Church. It's wrong. That was why those people that were coming, I see them with their phone, started pressing and saying, please move that person out. Please. Any person you are ushering, tell the person off your phone. Now, we have pastors here. Don't you have phone? Why didn't you bring it inside church? Please, let's be reasonable. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? If you are going for a board meeting, will you carry your phone? Why wouldn't you carry your phone? We are going to take this message in three series. The first one is impartation of power. The second one is impartation of wisdom. And the third one is impartation of the spirit of faith. Every opportunity you have to partake of an impartation is an opportunity for a change of status. Destinies are upgraded by impartation. You experience greater grace by impartation. There is an appointed destination for everyone, but you need impartation to move you from face to face. Paul said, I long to see you that I may impart on you, which means he has seen them before. So every time you are privileged to be imparted, your destiny experiences a positive push. Into the plan and purpose of God for your life. You can't be imparted and be limited. In fact, impartation is the cure for your limitation. Impartation is the cure for your stagnation. Impartation is the cure for your frustration. There are forces that can't fight you because of the things hovering around you. Thank God for that testimony that was read. After she laid hold on the mantle and placed it, you may call it religion, but it is scriptural. The force attacking her came again, but this time around, the mantle fought that devil back. I want to say to someone here, anyone that have made up their mind to fight you this year, the mantle will strike them. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. How come something that took place in the dream now happened in the physical? We live in a spiritual world. The dream world is the real spiritual world. So if you are careless about what happens to you in the dream, you will see it to come to pass. So as he hit her in the dream, in the physical, he hit her actually. Get ready. Whoever has pre-planned for you what they will do to you, the mantle will strike them. Amen. What is impartation? Impartation is the transference or the transfer of grace, of virtue, of spiritual authority to the receiver. So there is something transferred. And who initiates the transfer is God. The essence of the impartation of power is to enable you fulfill God's plan for your life. We live daily in a wicked world. And that is why it takes power to subdue the enemy and gain access to the blessings ordained for you. Yes, there is a place of fasting that will bring about power, but after the fasting, you need an impartation. You need an impartation. I am the Lord thy God that giveth thee power to get. There are things you can't get without power. Likewise, there are things that can't enter your hand without impartation. The world is full of hostility, enmity, hatred, without a cause. Whether you agree with me or not, there are obvious proofs and facts that people are angry with the small change that is in your hand. You are laughing. It takes power to handle such enemies. When power is at work, nobody rises against you and survives. That's why to be powerless in this season is to be wiped out. The enemy can just wipe you out. It takes power to silence all the enemies. Through the greatness of thy power shall thy enemies submit themselves unto thee. It takes power to silence negative reports. It takes power to quench the fiery darts of the wicked. When the evil man or woman makes an enchantment or declares some evil words, if you lack power, what the enchanted may come to pass. It takes power to blot out the handwriting of the enemy. It takes power. Without power, you can't access your inheritance and possess your possession. That is why we must go for impartation. We must go for impartation. Laying hold on your inheritance will be a struggle if impartation has not taken place. Much more impartation of power. Another thing impartation of power will bring about, it will bring about a change of our spiritual identity and authority. A change in spiritual identity and authority. Immediately, Elisha collected the mantle. Identity has changed. So what bowed for his master, bowed for him. I believe God that after this service, your identity will change. Yeah. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Yeah. If you lack power, you will suffer more affliction in the hand of the enemy. If you lack power, if there is anything you must not lack, it is power. I give unto you power to tread upon serpents and upon scorpions, and nothing shall by any means do what? Hurt you. So you need an impartation of power. What Elisha collected was the impartation of power. That was why immediately he collected the mantle. Jordan bowed. He parted. As this impartation of power comes upon you, whatever has not bowed for you before, we bow from today. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. Whatever represents Jordan in your life, we part ways for you in the name of Jesus. So you need to believe what is coming upon you. You can't cross the Red Sea. You can't part your own Jordan without the mantle. Likewise, if you are not seeing results in your life, it's a sign that you need a mantle. You need an impartation. You need an impartation. You need an impartation. What must I do to receive this impartation? Number one, you must be born again. Until Jesus becomes your Lord and your Savior, you are not entitled to an impartation. You can't serve two masters. Number two, you need the right heart. You need the right heart. You don't just be in church. You must also believe the place. You believe the place and believe your pastor. We live in a time where there is an epidemic of rebellion in the church. Where people come to church, constantly criticize, constantly speak against. How can such a person impart you? It no go work. That's why some people, when they are in a church, instead of their life to be appreciating in value, they are depreciating in value. Run for your life. Any pastor you can criticize or speak against can never be used of God as a channel to speak into your life. Never. In fact, an unbeliever will be more better off than you. That's why I say you need a right heart. There was a pastor that worked with Bishop Abue. He never believed him. He's going from worst to worst. I won't call his name. His condition is getting more worster. If there's any English word like that. Do you know why? His heart is not right. Even if somebody induces you to come and speak against your pastor, it's a sign you no get sense. The person is positioning your head for destruction and you still enter. That's why scripture says, believe the Lord thy God and thou shalt be established. Believe also his prophet, so shalt thou prosper. That word is very deep. Very deep. Bishop Abio said something the other day. That our heavenly father gives us a place in heaven. Our spiritual father gives us a place on the earth. So it is the impartation we receive from them that determine how things flourish for us here on earth. You need a right heart. One person that never had a right heart was Gehazi. He was following a prophet with an unction. Someone that collected the mantle from Elijah. Gehazi would have tripled the unction of Elijah and Elisha. But because his heart was not right. His heart was not right. Hear this. You either get the blessing or you get the leprosy. Which one do you want? God bless you. Gehazi got leprosy instead of the blessing. A right heart. The second one is receive the person and believe his ministry. He that receiveth a prophet in the name of a prophet shall get a prophet reward. If you have not received him, there is no way he can be used to bless you. You receive him before he can be a channel of blessing to you. Pastor come, pastor go, barak remain. Three of us. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
Pastor come, pastor go, barak remain, abi. But it is God's plan and program that everyone that comes must be used of him to advance your life, advance your family, advance your business. But if you don't understand it, you may end up getting stagnated, frustrated. Why? Lack of understanding. There's somebody I told one of my boys, don't follow this person again. He said, why, sir? Because of what you told me. He couldn't remember what he told me. The person was complaining against Papa. Bitterly. And his Papa's relation. I said, don't follow him again. If not, the thing where they follow and go follow you. So, after some months, the person was no longer seeing him again. So he now summoned courage. Pastor Tony said, I should not follow you. He said, why? He said, because you are always talking against Papa. So that the cause that is following you will not enter me. I'm not joking, though. How can they be holding service in Canaan land? The wife will go to redemption camp. It's a sign you don't believe who you are following. I said, leave that man alone. If you follow him, you go carry cause. And the cause started showing. That was when he was able to now confront the man. After that time, one day I was going to drop my children, so he traced me to the hotel. He said, I'm sorry. This is that. I said, no. It's a sign that you don't have spiritual understanding. Your father's brother has been used as a blessing globally. And yet you and your wife, you are suffering. I say, now bad spirit, they follow you and your wife. The wife can come in now. Because if you come in, I go look at her. Praise God. A prophet is not regarded in his hometown. People that speak against you more, they are people that think that they know you. Financially, God has used Papa to shoot many destinies up. spiritually, he has empowered many to fulfill destiny. Why can't your own work? Why can't your own work? He has repented, though. And I'm sure he has repented. And I've forgiven him. If not, I will be treating him like a devil. Because if you join the clique of people that are speaking against a servant of God, what follow them will follow you. The curse, the reproach, the evil that is to come to them, we must also enter you. One was speaking against Dr. Paul Enenche. A friend, though, he was a son of Paul Enenche. Somebody who is his friend was now speaking against Paul Enenche, and he was following the person. His ministry closed. From a large crowd, it is now where two or three are gathered. It's not a laughing matter. Many destinies have been wounded because of what I'm saying, instead of being upgraded. So he now entered fasting, thinking it was witches and wizards. The Holy Ghost now opened him up to the picture of the day he was talking with this other pastor that was speaking against Paul Enenche. Immediately, he showed him the picture couldn't leave him. He now went back and began to ask for forgiveness. Paul Enenche laughed. He said, when you were saying it, I was not there, but God was watching you. And when the evil began to follow you, didn't follow me. The person you are speaking against does not suffer the effect of what you are saying. You are the one that suffers it. See, you now say, he came for forgiveness. Eh? I pray for you. God show you mercy. Change your story. It is now left for you to whether go back or stay on your own. Shall I tell you something? It's better not to have a friend than to have one that will speak against your pastor or your prophet. Papa said something on Sunday. Fear a man that is honored. If you do anything to fight his honor, nothing will reduce, but you'll be the one that will be going down. But if you believe them, their honor comes upon you. And I've seen it work. There are some testimonies, sir. I may not be able to get all of them now. But as a result of the impartations that I've gotten from Papa, Bishop Abie, Bishop Aremu, Paul Enenche, Ebri Biomi, Johnson Suleiman, I can't remember all of them. I have 8 of them. I just discovered there are strange testimonies that just take place. I would just be wondering, when did this start? I just knew that it's a product of impartation. Product of impartation. Impartation. Which kind of fasting do I want to fast that they have not fasted? Okay, Papa has fasted more than 40 years. When did I start ministry? Talk now. This is 2018. I'm just 16 years. Can you compare his 40 years fasting with my 16 years? That's why impartation brings about a release of higher power. So what you couldn't do with your physical hand, or what you couldn't do as a person, because a higher power has come upon you, you begin to do those things. The mantle answered for Elisha. Because he believed, he said, wherever you go, I will go. I am following you bumper to bumper. And the thing answered. And when he confronted Jordan, Jordan bowed. Why? Because of the impartation. Number three, is it number three or number four? Number four, honor them in your heart. Who you honor, you value. Who you honor, you treasure. I treasure every moment I have with them. Very soon now, we take off and go and meet all of them for a fresh impartation for the takeoff of LFC Lafia. I treasure every moment, every moment. After the impartation I got from Pastor Jeme, I was delivered from struggle. You know, you can be a pastor and be a struggler. You go to struggle, then go to see him for your body. You go see him for your body, say, this man, he did struggle. He struggled to preach, he struggled to do, he even struggled to eat. God forbid. After that impartation, I was delivered of struggle. I entered the realm of creative teaching. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? When I encountered Bishop Abiyah, look, I received what they call ministry grace. Please, I beg you, 2018, you are not permitted to struggle. Yeah. This impartation that is about to come to you, it works for business. It works for career. It works for family. Amen. Any area of your life that needs a manifestation of power, it will answer for you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Number five, crave for what they carry. Crave for what they carry. Earnestly desire what they carry. Long to have the thing transferred upon you. Crave for what they carry. I've been listening to all of their tapes. You know, messages as a way of imparting you. I've been listening to all of their tapes. Until when it was face to face. And I knew that it's a seal. You must crave for what they carry. Bishop Aremu have what we call praying grace. It's a praying machine. I told him, so after this fasting, I just said, I should let you know that I'm coming to see you. He said, okay, just be on your way. When you are ready, just let me know. It's a praying machine. And it has what we call prayer resort. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? So when he places his hand, the grace to get result in prayer answers. You don't struggle. Are you hearing what I'm saying now? Yes, all of them, you must crave for what they carry. Bishop Abiyah has teaching grace. Sweatless teaching. There are some people, when they are preaching, they will be wiping their face 20 times. But scripture says, as Jesus began to teach, the power of God was present to heal. That's the kind I like. You don't struggle to preach, but you can't deny the effect of what is being released. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
It's as simple as that. And another thing that increased my addiction, after Mommy Oyedepo, who is next? Who is next? In line of impartation, who is next? Good. So he's a major recipient of everything that has dropped on Bishop David Oyedepo. So that's why for his own I go every month. Every what? so that I will be disgracing every devil hanging around your life. So you see, each of them, he also has the gift of administration. What to do at the right time, what not to do, what to avoid, what not to say. Dr. Polinenche has fire and deliverance. True of us? So after listening to the first encounter, I said, I've been seeing you in my dream. You'll be telling me these things. He said, now you are here physically. Pow! What you don't believe cannot work for you. David Ibiomi has unusual healing anointing. Unusual. When I mean unusual, unusual. Maybe I've mentioned it before. The day I went there, it was war. He didn't see me. I didn't know he was watching me from a camera. I couldn't even see the camera, but the camera was seeing me. He told me that, hey, I'm seeing you. You are reading one book. I sat down. The pastor that followed me was very angry. He said, sir, let's go. I said, I came all the way from Benin. You can't go. You don't need this thing. I said, you don't need this thing. You can go. Take transport money. I gave him 10,000. Charter taxi. From here and now you have reached Asaba. Go. So as I finished the book, Holy Spirit, my helper, his book, I started praying there. All of a sudden, around 2:05, he just came out. He just laughed. He said, Tony, come. He said, I've been watching you from the camera. I wanted to see the content of your heart to know what I will do, whether I will just discharge you immediately. So as we entered, he started telling me some coded secrets on what to do and ministry will flourish, what not to do, what to use per time. After that, he blessed me and gave me one of his mantles for healing. I hope you know, Ibiomi is duplicating the grace of Papa. Without sweat. Hear me and hear me well. You have suffered enough. From today, suffering will die in your life. Then the last I will mention for time's sake. I've been listening to Apostle Suleiman because he's also a follower of Papa. Secretly. Yes, he's a follower of Papa secretly. One night I had a funny encounter. He was praying for people. When he got to my turn, he said, I should lie down. I lied down. He laid on me. And he like this. Ah! I said, no, fire is burning my heart. He said, you need this fire. Because there are devils you will meet on your way. So when you hear me shout, die! You go know where the madness they come from. So I now visited him one time. They had a program. So in that program, I was not sitting in front. I was sitting somewhere around the third row or the fourth row. He said, come. As he laid down on me, I don't know what carried me. They threw away me. He said, they should pick him up, bring him back. He fired another one. He said, pick him up. He fired another one. I couldn't understand. It's like I was no longer in the church. So he said, after the service, you should see me. He said, something has entered. But I will tell you what to do to sustain it. If you lack impartation, you cannot survive your journey. Your journey will be so distorted, so frustrated. Okay, how much more, Sam Adeyemi? A quiet preacher. But because of the series of impartation he has been collecting, they are running 5 services. So, how many? 5. 5. People that believe in impartation, they are on the fast lane of life. People that don't believe in impartation, they are on the slow lane of life. So you must crave for what they carry. Number 4, which is the last one, you must engage. Number 6, you must engage in a sonship tie with your prophet. Until your heart answers to his heart, what he carries cannot flow to you. You must engage in a sonship tie. You must believe him in your heart. You must long for him in your heart. Until that is in place, there is no connectivity and there is no collection. Until you connect, you can't collect. Until you connect, you can't do what? Collect. Believe in impartation, they experience what we call prophetic open heaven. Say with me, prophetic open heaven. You have a prophetic destiny, but you also need a prophet that will bring you into that experience. I send my angel ahead of you to prepare you and to bring you into the place that I have prepared for you. So they bring you into the things God has prepared for you. So I want to let you know that this impartation is going to end struggle in your life. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. Any devil arranged to molest you on the way, to fight you on the way, this year will be dangerous for them. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. We used to have a member. They call her Mama London because the daughter is in London. So they are now calling her Mama London. She attended our impartation service, one of the services, and DHL the mantle to the daughter. She has been believing God for the fruit of the womb for 11 years. So the daughter was religiously doing the same thing that sister did. Miraculously, she became pregnant. Miraculously, no prayer, not that. And funny enough, he's not even a member of the church. But after, she took him, gave birth, became a member of the church. If God can do that one, he will do your own. Amen. If you are saying amen, say better amen. Amen. I say, we do your own. Amen. Maybe there is a veil of misfortune following you. It will take power to address it. There are people that suffer rejection, whether in marriage or in career or in their job. When the mantle come upon you, He said, and on this mountain shall the Lord of hosts remove the veil and the covering cast. So whatever looked like a veil of wickedness, a veil of shame, a veil of rejection, a veil of disappointment, as the mantle come upon you, that evil veil will leave your life in the name of Jesus. So immediately you have established this, the next thing is, Lord, this is my catch-up moment. I must not miss this impartation. I must not miss this impartation. Whatever you have in store for me that has been flowing through this mantle, let it answer in my life. Let it answer to my challenge. Let it answer to my expectation. They got not the land in possession by their arm. Oh, I just remember the testimony now. Now, when our pastors were sent to Nairobi, Kenya, they refused granting them residence permit and working permit. So they were holding fellowship in hidden places. So Bishop Abiy visited. After Bishop Abiy visited, they told him that this is exactly what's happening. Just carried the mantle. They drove to the immigration, this thing, and did it like this. Say with me like this. Just like this. The following day, they called them to come and take their papers. Anything you believe, that's what will work. Don't believe it will not work. That young man that we had the testimony carried the mantle and hit the goods and say goodbye. How many of us still have our Shiloh mantle? Yeah, some people know reason. If you don't have Shiloh mantle, raise your hand. Jesus. Raise your hand well. I want to see you. Don't lie, yo. If you lie and I give it to you, it will not work. Okay. Immediately after the service, come and queue beside my car. Pastor Madawa and Pastor Gbenga will give to you. Then for all of you that have your mantle, as you go home, no evil will take place in this house. You go to your business, no more stagnation. Amen. Open heaven. Amen. Every goose here, I command buyers to locate you. Watch out, there will be commotion in your life. Commotion of favor. Commotion of blessings. Commotion of open doors. The devil that will stop you in 2018, they have not born that devil. Rise up to your feet. You are going to lift up your voice to pray. Lord, let this be my own moment. Whatever look like a Jordan, whatever look like an invisible barrier, whatever look like a veil of shame, whatever look like an unseen power fighting your purpose and plan in my life, as this impartation come upon me, Lord, let the barriers be broken. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Neketerio Jacu Capreketesiso, Dosuli Preketesosa, Menteredi en Juzale Carota, Lecote, Brelu Shakata, Razeze Kikoto, Laporeto, Licarete Keteke, Liho Shaganaga Reketezia, Leon Preglike to Suzuna E, Lecato Riambaladosha, Leze Delica Bracata, Rezuzale, Bredijo de, Lezo Recotelete. La poteclo prepedi daba. Le kota prakatakata. Jekoteke preketelia. Let this impartation deliver me from struggle. End my trials. Deliver me from frustration. Deliver me from stagnation. Le kato pare ete rita lo shada. Mendredi le shuze ziga lekete. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we have prayed. All eyes closed, all heads bowed. You are here, you are not born again. If this impartation must profit you, Jesus must be Lord and Savior in your heart. Wherever you are right now, you want to give your life a new touch, put your right hand on your chest and say this prayer after me. Lord Jesus, I come unto you today. I know that I'm a sinner. Forgive me. Wash me with your precious blood. I reject sin. I reject Satan. Come into my life. Be my Lord. Be my Savior. In Jesus' name I pray. If you pray that prayer with me wherever you are, just carry your bag and your Bible and come quickly. I want to pray with you. You are going to do your own impartation in front here. Put your hands together for Jesus. If you are coming, come quickly. Come. God bless you. You don't need to be ashamed. This is your consolation. If you are coming, come quickly.
Purify me. Creating me. Happy.
Jesus, unto them that come unto you, shall you in no wise cast out. They've accepted Jesus Christ as their Lord and as their Savior. I pray this morning that the guilt of their past, they are rolled away. Every curse, every accusation of the wicked, let it be blotted out. In Jesus' name I pray. As this oil come upon you, I decree today, mark a new dawn in your life. Your days of frustration, they are over. Whatever has been fighting you mysteriously, I end the assignment physically. In the name of Jesus Christ. Please still remain standing. As this mantle come upon you right now, pastors, please. Just one touch, you move to the next person in case you came with your handkerchief. I want you to pray from the depth of your heart. Anything that is not done in faith is sin. Yes. Put it on your head right now. As you do, you pass it on in the name of Jesus Christ. Le rocha kote preklete zezia. Lamborato zekulatana. Put it on your own head and begin to pray. Begin to pray. Le roba shando sete liankata. Nerodo shikusate la rendo blegdi sata. La potekle kikoto zizo nande de. Rezuzalia plekletuzaza, lekoprakatali ande reketeliza, rejonanga daga, leri ande ledosha, lera dakiko to praklatozaze, mekiko prakatoni ande leketelita, rosho dodo rikatose suzeni. Lord, by this impartation, my destiny go forward. By this impartation, Living Faith Church Lafia enter new realms of glory, new realms of wonders, new realms of manifestation, new realms of breakthrough, new realms of manifestation of power. By this impartation, I step into a new order of favor, new order of progress. La poreketes is an endada. Every Jordan will bow. Landeredu shangala yagadagadaga. Zekoteke lika protozizona lendo brakata tete riso seke prekota liato lerusha gagaga resonangleri deguziza lekata. Lift up your voice and pray. Every manipulation, any force that has vowed that you will not make progress this year, by the mantle, their assignment come to an end. Legaro shanda yaga daga 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 da. Zesu rekete plekete. Rebadusi tolekete liya. Lambredie sete liya gada gada gada. Laborate klikete rosana gada gada gada. Le kata le ura ba le gudezi le gada gada gada. Declare from the depths of your heart what you want to see take place. Lord, I believe your this mantle. Let it answer for my breakthrough. Resha barado city le ambre glido suso nige dege dege de le kato prakato zezuzezia enagege rushatolia rekota breketeni nasido elo prekete suso jakukate yata lempora dege 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 dege. Lord, by this impartation, La rata catalis, Ezusa nege brege de rosis aligada. My story is changing for the better. My story is changing for the better. I am breaking forth. I am entering my realms of unlimited progress. Whatever bow to my prophets, we bow to me this year. Le ran de kli kote roji kote te ya. Zedo rodo bregedede. Le katari ande le doros. Neso leke prekete liya. Le katar le ande le bo shagada. Lord, by this mantle, let your unstoppable hand be seen in my life, be seen in my wife, be seen in my children, be seen in my family, be seen in Living Faith Church Lafia. Rikata yanda labosh, nazise like prekoteloza. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. For those of you that have, raise it up. As I wave, you wave. I decree from today, the heavens open for you. The heavens open for your family. The heavens open for your business. Any monetary mirror they are using to manipulate you, by this mantle, let their base catch fire. Let their evil high priest die. Your Jordan will part ways for you. You will not suffer limitation this year. You will not suffer stagnation. You will not struggle to eat. That business enjoy open heaven. Your expectation come to pass speedily. No more reproach in your life. No more diversion of blessing. Say a big amen. It on your head. If you don't have, use your hand and put on your head, because you will get one after now. Wherever they are enchanting you, from today they will not see you. Wherever they are calling your name for evil, the vengeance of the God of Jericho answer against them. Say amen like a believer. Whoever is the strong man that is on assignment against you, the same way the mantle smits that woman in the dream, that mysterious attacker attacking you in your dream, let them be smitten by the mantle. If you are saying amen, say better amen. 2018, you will not struggle. You will not struggle to eat. You will not struggle to build house. You will not struggle with your business. Uncommon doors open for you. If you are saying amen, say better amen. What others are struggling to get, this year it will be cheaply delivered in your hand. So shall it be. Anyone overdue for marriage, by this mantle, I release you into your marriage. Wherever your God ordained husband is or your wife is, by the four winds of the Spirit, be located. If you are saying amen, say better amen. No blessing appointed for you will be aborted this year. Say amen like a believer. It is done. In Jesus' name. Wave your hand unto God and give him glory. Blessed be your name, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name. Put your hands together for Jesus and please take your seat. Please just turn and follow this man.